Hello, my name's Kyle, and I'm the current head projectionist at L&L. And what you're seeing around me is the projection booth. The projection booth is located in Fuller at WPI, and if you walk in the front door of Fuller and you go to the left, you'll find Upper Parole Lecture Hall, and to the left of Upper Parole Lecture Hall is this tiny little, kind of looks like hallway with some stairs, and at the top of that, it says projection booth. So that's how you get there. This video is what we're calling Pit 1, Projectionist in Training, and this is the first level. So anyone who knows nothing about film, myself included when I came here, can watch this video to learn more about projection in the booth. And we'll go over such things as sound, lighting, and basic operations such as projection screen. All right, first thing we're gonna go over is sections of the projection booth.
The first spot we have in the booth is the bench. We use the bench to assemble and disassemble 35 millimeter films, trailers, and just general work. You can see we have different things called splicers, which help us fix film when it's bad or put it together, and all other assorted stuff such as a cleaner, storing some film, just miscellaneous stuff. So it's a good thing to know. It's called the film bench. The next thing we have is the sound rack. And the sound rack is where, as you can probably guess, is where all the sound is controlled by. This thing right here is called a CP650, and it's how we control sound between different inputs in the booth. You can see different ones here, and they're all labeled computer, 16mm AES, 70mm or 6 channel, Dolby Digital, Dolby SR, Dolby A-Type, and Mono. The different ones, computer, as you can guess, goes to computer, 16 switches to 16. Millimeter film. AES is the digital projector. 70 millimeter and 6 channel is either, depending on how we're using it, is either the 70 millimeter magnetic or using the Blu-ray player 5.1. Dolby Digital is the standard we use for 35 millimeter, and we pretty much don't use the other three mono, Dolby A-Type or Dolby SR, so you don't have to care about that too much. Here we have the sound knob, and this is how we adjust the sound, as you can guess. Standard one is 7.0, and for quieter films, we up it accordingly, or louder films, we lower it accordingly. Bypass here, you push, and it turns off, and it bypasses. We don't really care about that too much, and you probably shouldn't push it. Anyway, such things we have over here are all the amplifiers in the booth, which power the audio. Down here are the ones that go down to the hall. And in over here are the ones that go inside. Over here we have a patch bay where we can jump audio from one place to another for debugging and such. You shouldn't touch any of this stuff unless the crew chief tells you you can. And over here we have this thing called the MQP of Death, which keeps track of the lamp hours on the 35mm projectors, which is important because the lamps have a certain date. And basically, we have no idea how this works, so don't touch it. Also, this is the official booth time. Whatever this time says is what time it is. It doesn't matter if it says 3 p.m. and it's 9 p.m. This is the time. This is our fridge. Normally, we keep food in there, but we can't, so we won't. This is a TJ. He stays here and monitors the booth 24/7. Next, we have the 16mm projectors, which when you first enter the door over here, you come in, and here are the 16mm projectors. The 16mm projectors are a smaller format than the 35mm projectors, and things that used to be released on here include commercials, home films, films you could take home. Basically, this is all just like stuff that's easy to get a hold of on eBay these days and other stuff. We like to, if you want to see what it actually looks like, take the cover off and you can see that's what the basic projector looks like. That's the second pit. 16mm projection is what we'll get to in the second pit. But for now, all I need to know is where it is and what it is. You can hear that. Okay, over here, we have the magical 35mm projectors. The 35 and 70, I should say that. The 35 and 70mm projectors are how film used to be played, basically from the early 1900s all the way up until 2014. We have some really special 35 and 70 millimeter projectors, and we can do such things with them as watch actual full movies. We own some movies such as B Movie, Apollo 13, Men in Black, Open Season, and Daredevil. We'll go over more of this one in Pit 4, but for now, what you need to know is where it is and what it is. Here are the three types of film that we use in the projection booth. In the middle here is 16mm film. You can tell because it's the smallest of the three. Each one only has one sprocket hole. It only has mono sound, which is on the right side. And it fits in our 16mm projectors. Over here is our 35mm. Is some 35mm film. And you can tell because it's not the biggest, which is over here. And it also has a ton of different sound options. We have the optical, which is the line that runs through. We have the dots and dashes, which are DTS. We have, you can't see it in this shot, but you have the QR codes in between the sparkle holes, which is Dolby Digital. And then on the outsides of both, the blue, is SDDS. We only use the optical and the Dolby Digital. And then lastly, over here, is the 70mm film. In this case, it's a 70mm magnetic film. And you can tell it's 70 because it is thick. And it also is just awesome. The sound is run on the sides using magnets, which is basically the same thing as like a cassette tape only printed onto the film. Next we have in the booth, the digital projector. The digital projector is the newest and funnest toy. This bad boy can put out 2K resolution, does 5.1, 7.1, we still only support 5.1, and is basically how all movies come to us. This thing can be used from the computer, which is down here. We can get stored movies on it off the NAS, which is also there. We have a Blu-ray player right there, which we can play stuff by using that cable snake. And it's all controlled by this panel right here. Now, it's a little bright. All right, well, this is a Pit 3, which we'll get to later. But that's just good to know what's over here. Also, the computer is right here. It runs Windows. And the password is given to you if you ever come in the booth. Side note, location is this magical place right here. If you actually see, that looks like the door we came in, but it's not. It's in fact a, drum roll please, bathroom. Yeah, that's it. Currently, due to COVID, we're not allowed to use the bathroom, but I've never used it anyway. We also have here the electrical panel for the booth where we can control everything. Don't touch this unless the crew chief or head projectionist allows you to. All right, the next thing we're going to learn here is the lighting controls in the projection booth. Over here we have the lights for the hall, and numbers 1 through 4 are the standard ones that the professors and everyone else can access down there. But then we have the magical ones, 5 through 8. Start 5 is pre-show, and pre-show basically makes it a little dark, primarily behind the screen, so that the projector, you know, you can still see stuff on the projector. Number 6 is previews, and that gets pretty dark with the exception of the side lights, so you could still leave or enter if you need. 7 is pitch black, which is movie. And 8 is credits, which is actually the same thing as previews, because you want a little light, but not too much. Safety comes first. Also over here is max and off. If you ever need to turn on all the lights at once, you press max, or just off, press off. And lastly, each one of these has a fader. So if you hop between 5 and 6, it'll slowly dim and make your eyes all nice and happy. But sometimes, such as an emergency or something, you'd want to make it instantly bright. So what you would do is, instead of pushing it once, you'd push it twice. So click, click, and then it will become nice and bright instantaneous and hurt your eyes. But light hurts your eyes less than fire does, so we'll do that. What else we have over here? The lights for in the booth. 35mm area, 16mm, and bench. So for example, if I lower the bench, see, bench. 16mm is the 16mm area, and 35 is 35. On and off down here, and then dimmers. Red light is up there. Notice we have a red light. Turn off all the lights in here. Cool. Boop, boop. We use that during a showtime so that you can still see, but yet we're not distracting the audience. Excuse me. Other light switches we have, they don't have to worry about too much. Exhaust fan. We have a exhaust in here. Heating controls. We always keep it on cold because it gets hot in here. And then last right here are the controls for the projector down there. The classroom projector goes up and down because it's in our way, but they've installed a nice thing that we can raise it when we're projecting so it's not in our way. And I will attach a video of it going up and down to show you, so I'm going to talk a little longer. But basically you hold down and it goes down until it stops. It won't break if you keep holding it down, it'll just stop on its own. Same thing with up, you hold it up until it stops going up. It has its own limit switches and you won't break it, so don't worry about that. The most important thing in the booth is safety. In case of fire, there is two fire extinguishers located in the projection booth. One behind the 60mm projectors right here, and two is the other one when you first enter the door on the left. In case of fire in the booth, get out. But before you get out, please make sure to turn on all lights in the hall and make sure to notify authorities and to make sure people get out of the hall before you yourself leave. A few other things we're going to try here, just little things to know about the booth right here, is one of our two filing cabinets. The first level is the files cabinet. You open it up and we have files for years and years and years back. It's a nice thing. We also have old little strips of previews beforehand that we can put in some movies. You can look at anything you want except for the last chunk over here. That's only the head projectionist can see. And then in the other two cabinets, we currently store tons and tons of 35mm previews. This is scope, which we'll learn more about the different formats a little later. Down here is more scope. And then on the other side of the booth, we have more filing cabinet. Top one up here is just the miscellaneous head projectionist drawer. You shouldn't really go into there. And then two more flat ones, which is just more previews. Welcome to the actual Fuller Upper. As you can see, this lecture hall is a lecture hall, but we can fix that. Pardon my knocking the camera. The first step we do, take the curtain, this giant black curtain. We're gonna pull it across. Now we have our first layer, which is now the black. And we then do is this magical lock right here. If you can see, there's some arrows on it. Turning it one way will lower it, and turn the other way will raise the screen. I will now show this. Here, underneath the booth, we have what we like to call the graveyard. And the graveyard can be accessed using the same key for the projection booth. In this case, the flip key on the HP projection ring. What we normally store down here is old projectors and other equipment that has no business being in the booth when in use. You're probably wondering, why is there this giant sign that says safety film only permitted in this room? What's that? Well, I'll tell you. Film before 1951 used to be made out of something called nitrate. It was called nitrate film. Nitrate film, as the name kind of implies, would go boom boom when flames would touch it. And I don't know if you know this, but projectors shine a very hot light onto film to make the light go through onto the screen. So as you can probably guess, fire plus explosive film equals a no-no. So after 1951, film was made out of something called acetate film, and then later polyester film, which is non-flammable. It will still melt a little bit, but it won't actually combust. So that's why we have this sign, safety film only permitted in this room. And it also used to be a Massachusetts state law that required us to put two of these signs. One here, and one I'm not cutting any of this out, and one right there. Safety film only permitted in this room. So
true. And as you know, here at L&L,
safety is number one priority. All right, there you have it. That's your Pit 1 Projectionist and Training 1 guide. If you have any questions, please ask in the comments or talk to the current head projectionist, whoever that may be. Please leave a like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.